I never had boundaries. I did anything I wanted to do, anytime I wanted to do it, anywhere I wanted to do it, with anybody I wanted to do it with.
I met Danny on a fashion shoot. When someone is touching your face and touching your hair, you become somewhat conversationally intimate with that person almost instantly. And when I met him, he was still Mr. Fabulous. I mean, he had on his black cashmere and he was drinking his martini and living on top of the world. And at the time, I didn't realize that he was on the beginning of the slide downward.
As a hairdresser, makeup artist for a lot of celebrities and fashion magazines, and you know, at one time I was pulling in $3,000 a day. That was my rate for me being in the studio. But that kind of all fell apart. You know, I began to overdose a lot on photo shoots, and once you start overdosing, you cross a line, and when you cross that line, you become an insurance risk, and suddenly I was more or less blackballed in the business.
Did you know who you were? Did you have any kind of sense of who you were?
No, I absolutely didn't. You know, even when I was at the height of this amazing career, I always was the guy who felt out of place. So I always felt like I didn't really belong. I always felt like empty and lonely and just like out of place.
It was through relationship, through time, and through listening to some of the details of his life, and then through kind of seeing him sliding downward, that I knew this is someone I have to share the gospel with.
I just thought she was crazy, to be honest with you. I thought she was like a religious fanatic. That was my impression. And she's a beautiful girl, she's really sweet, but she's a religious fanatic.
By the time our lives had become intertwined, he was losing weight at a very fast clip. He was no longer wearing cashmere. I had the sense of, wow, if he doesn't find God, he's going to die. He's going to die.
Drugs had just taken me to a point where my whole world had collapsed, and I took a garbage can and I pulled it between my legs and I began to cut up anything that had my name on it. I cut it up and I walked out of a 5,000 square foot loft and pulled the door behind me, and I just never went back, and I began to live on the street.
But why did you cut up your cards? Why did you destroy your identity?
I think I just didn't want, I knew that I would die on the street. And I didn't want to be recognized. I didn't want my family to be called. I was resigned to the fact that I was going to die on the street, and that was it.
Did you do drugs out here?
Oh, yeah, sure. Just sit around here and shoot dope. I mean, in the mornings, you'd see just all syringes around here. I had an agent that I used to call from the streets every couple of days, collect from a payphone, and every once in a while she would say, this girl Wanda, this model from Ford's been calling, you know, she wants you to call her. I distinctly remember this, her saying to me, you know, Danny, the day you call on the name of the Lord, he's going to set you free. And I said, well, you know what, that'll never happen because I will never call on the name of the Lord. She said, well, I just want you to remember that, you know, when you're really backed up against the wall, when you call on the name of the Lord, he's going to set you free. I had begun to develop a lot of phobias and a lot of fears and things that were just unnatural, you know. And then I started developing a lot of voices in my head, you know, where one voice just started spewing filthy language in my head, just filthy words, like unconnected, disjointed, filthy words, while the other voice was accusing, and then another voice had joined in that was just laughing and laughing and laughing. I had gone from this kind of celebrated, you know, person to this crazy man living on the streets of New York, talking to themselves, laughing, cursing, like an animal living on the street.
I was starving to death. I had gotten down to 108 pounds. I had hepatitis A, hepatitis B, hepatitis C all at the same time.
I got off the train, I remember that, and I remember kind of stumbling to this hospital that I saw. When I woke up, I was in a hospital bed, and I was laying like in my own vomit. And all the voices were screaming in my head. But there was just one moment where I heard like a sweet voice that said, "The day you call on the name of the Lord, He's going to set you free." And then right behind it, all the voices kept screaming in my head. And then again, I heard that the day you call on the name of the Lord, He's going to set you free. And that's when I began to just cry out to God. And you know, just, I didn't know how to pray. I didn't know really what I was saying. I was just saying, you know, "Jesus, help me, save me. You're my only hope. I have no other hope." You know. And that's the moment that I'll never forget. Because it was like at that moment that the Spirit of the living God just swept into that hospital room. At that moment, all of the voices in my head stopped. And like all the fears and all the phobias just dropped away from me. And I knew that I was in the presence of God. I knew that the Spirit of God was in the room healing me and changing me. I went directly from that hospital into a Christian rehab. And I just began to devour God's Word, you know? It was like I was like a hungry man just feasting on the Word of God.
I opened this letter and it's from Danny. And he began to tell me about how he had become a Christian.
I came and I stayed with her and her husband in their apartment, and we went to Brooklyn Tabernacle. Pastor Cimbala said something from the pulpit. I was like sitting in the second row and said, "You want to hear a great miracle?" He goes, "You think God parting the Red Sea was a big miracle? Well, Danny Velasco got saved and he's sitting right there." And the place went nuts. They all knew me as this 108-pound drug addict, you know, that was living on the street. And they had all been praying for me. I know that God is real and that He heard me and that He was as close as the mention of His name. And whoever calls on the name of the Lord will be saved.